But you gotta be there for me too.
And I'm here with another video. Today I am doing a tutorial on this blue smoky eye. I also have a really poppin' highlight here, which I'll show you how to get. And I also have a metallic glitter lip here. So if you guys want to know how to do this look, just keep on watching. If you are not subscribed to my channel, make sure you are subscribed by clicking that button down there. Also, like this video up. Let's try to get it to 20,000 likes. I know we can do it. And follow me on all my social medias if you are not already. Let's get into the okay, so to start off this look, I already have my face prepped and primed. Actually, I'm gonna do like an illuminizing spray first, just to keep my face hydrated. I'm gonna be taking a full coverage foundation. Any one for this look would be fine. If you're not a full coverage kind of gal or guy, then you can just totally go sheer, whatever you want. But I'm gonna use a full coverage today. So I'm excited, because I always go in with like sheer ones, but I've been dying to try this one. So I hope it's good. Apparently all you need is like three dots, but of course I'm so extra. I always go for like way, way, way too much. I think I definitely went in a little too much with this foundation. However, it's looking good. Dipping in to concealer, I'm also using a super full coverage one because I want to go for a full coverage kind of look today. So I'm just using this under my eyes, and I love how creamy this concealer is. I'm living for it. So I'm using this brush, and I like this one for, it has a concealer brush to apply it, and then you flip it over and you get this like flat top blending. I'm living for this brush. And this brush is my Crown AC009. I'm all over the place, you guys. I have been traveling. I am honestly so tired, but I wanted to make sure I got a video out for you guys because I have been slacking on those. So I'm doing this. I also wanted to mention that I left my camera on my plane, and it had three videos filmed because I was collaborating with other YouTubers while I'm out there. And I was so bummed because there were such great videos, and now I can't post them because I lost my stupid camera. I'm praying to God and Jesus that I'll get it back. Where we went to the airport, my mom went to the airport to pick up my sister, and while she's there, she's gonna look at the lost and found. So I'm hoping that they pull through and get me my camera back. But if not, you're gonna have to live with it. Luckily, I had my old camera that still works perfectly fine. So if the video quality has like staged down just a little bit, that is why. I'm planning on getting a new camera if I can't find it, but I have a pretty good feeling that I'm gonna get it back. So just, I'm gonna stay tuned with that. I love a full coverage look. Now I understand what everyone's deal with this is. So dipping into this contour palette by Kat Von D, I'm gonna be, that was powdery. I'm gonna just be bronzing up my face. With my bronzing contour, I like to do circular motions. Just gives it a really nice bronzing effect. And I'm going for a more bronzy than like blushed look, because we are doing a pretty glamorous, deep, smoky eye. And then taking a cooler shade. I love using a cooler shade to contour my face because it just makes me look so sculpted. You guys, I haven't done makeup on myself in such a long time. I was like missing it. I was really looking forward to doing it. Okay, so now moving in with a flat top brush, I'm gonna be using this same cool shade to slim my nose. I'm still probably not like the queen by any means on any of this, but especially not nose contouring. I actually am really horrible at it, but I feel like I'm getting, starting to get the hang of it. And oh my gosh, does it make a huge difference. So I'm gonna do my eyebrows and prime my eyelids off of camera, and I will be right back. Okay, so now that my eyes are primed, I have four different eyeshadow palettes in front of me. I'm gonna be doing like a blue smoky eye. So yeah, first one I'm dipping into is the Real Her palette, taking the shade Strong as my transition shade. I really want this to be a cool tone smoky eye because it is blue. It will be a blue smoky eye, so I'm taking cooler tones so it goes with the blue. I enjoy using transition shades because it just helps blending so much easier. Okay, so now that we have the transition shade, I'm going to be dipping into this brown shade in my 35K palette, and I will just be deepening the outer V and the crease. Okay, so now that we're building up this dark smoky eye, I'm gonna be moving into an even darker cool brown shade. I'm gonna use this shade right here. Okay, so now that we're building up that smoky effect, we're just gonna keep going in deeper and deeper and deeper with darker shades, doing the same thing, deepening it really hardcore in this outer V and then blending it into the crease. Ooh, honey, so I'm living for how this is looking as of right now. So dipping back into the Real Her palette, I'm gonna be taking the dark, dark, dark black that's in here, Smart, and I'm gonna be using that to just further smoking out this smoky eye. A little bit too in with that black. As you can see, it's starting to become a full-on glamorous smoky eye, which is exactly what we want it to. So yeah, it's pretty easy. You just take light shades and then work into the darker shades so it doesn't look muddy, and it's super, super easy to blend. So since I have blue eyes, I thought it'd be really cool to take a dark navy blue. So I'm taking my Pavia's Place palette, and I'm going to be taking these two purple-ish blue shades, and I think it's gonna really accent my eyes gorgeously. Make it open. Okay guys, so this is the finished eye look. Now we're gonna be moving into lips. I got a huge PR package from MAC. They literally sent me every single lipstick shade. I like this a lot. So honestly, I'm probably like the worst person ever at applying lipstick. That's why whenever I do someone's makeup, I tell them, you know what? You apply your own lipstick, because I have a difficult time doing it on myself, let me tell you. So I like to take a concealer brush and clean up. So I'm going back into the Juvia's Place, sorry. I've been saying that wrong. I got on a teeth. I've been saying it wrong the entire time, but I'm taking that same pastel blue shade, giving me a glitter lip. And that is the finished look, y'all. Oh my God. I'm gonna be taking my Artist Couture highlighter. This is in the shade Illuminati. So with dust highlighters like Artist Couture, you got to spray your face. Oh my God. Just a little bit in that highlight region. Just like a little bit right there. And then instead of actually like going in and like swooping it back and forth like you would do a regular highlighter, you have to pat it. And then that is how you get a really poppin' highlight. But I'm sorry, I didn't mean to blind you or anything. So you guys, this is the finished look. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. It's probably my favorite look I've ever done so far. I just feel like I'm getting better and better as a makeup artist, and every look that I've been doing, I've just been like, this is my favorite, ooh, this is my favorite. So I'm definitely getting better, and this one is by far my favorite so far. So if you guys like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and follow me on Instagram. I post there all the time, and I just hit 2 million Instagram followers, which is absolutely insane. So thank you all so much for that. Subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already, and turn off those post notifications, and I will see you guys later with another video. Bye!